All right, we're going to talk about recording wires, EFTs, and ACH payments. So if this is a bill that we paid by wire, EFT, or ACH, we still want to go in to pay bills. And we're going to select the bill that we're going to pay. And instead of marking it to be printed down here, right, because probably if we sent it by wire or something, we've had to contact the bank, that we're not printing anything. But the method that we're sending it is still going to be a check, okay, because in QuickBooks, cash out of a bank account is a check, unless you're doing transfer or journal entry. But cash out is a check. That's how it should be. Instead of choosing print, we're going to say assign a check number. We choose the checking account we're wiring out of, EFTing out of, etc. And then we say pay the select bill. Now in the check number here, since we don't really have a check number, we put in wire. And then maybe if we have room for it, right? Wire 05-18-16 as an example. Or wire whatever reference number they give you. Okay. Now that bill's paid, the check number is wire, so we remember, right? I'm not looking for a check somewhere. I'm not looking for a check stub in my paperwork. I'm looking for a wire transfer form or confirmation from the bank. So that's paying bills using wire. Also, if it's not to pay a bill, if it's something that we're just cutting a check for, right now, it's not something that's going to flow through accounts payable, then when we can come in and just write the check, right? We choose a checking account. Again, the number up here is going to be wire, EFT, whatever it is, the date, who we're paying, the amount, and then we would fill in down below. Okay, but sometimes people are looking for how do I mark it as a wire payment? So the best way to do that is in this reference number here. You can put some additional information in the memo, but I found that the reference number is the best way.